Size 22 Michelle is on her way to the boutique with mum Kath and sister-in-law Emma. Michelle used to be a size 30 and has recently lost 5 stone, but that's come with a whole new set of problems.
You get looser skin, you know, and you start getting a bit droopy. It's weird because you think I'm doing such a positive thing, but it does add a whole lot of more insecurities onto it.
Michelle's so worried about finding a dress, she's starting early. Her wedding to fiancé Kerry isn't for another 18 months.
Hello, Michelle.
Hello.
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 How are you, ladies?
Slightly dreading seeing myself in a dress. Because at the minute, I don't feel like I will find a dress, and I think that's why I've started so early.
Right.
It's really difficult as a mum to see your child losing that self-confidence. She still believes she's really,
yeah,
really big.
What would your perfect dress be?
I don't really know.
Right, so we'll start with a clean slate there then.
Yeah, I don't like my arms.
And you're not planning drastic weight loss or anything?
I've already lost a lot of weight, 5.5 stone.
Oh, so... well done you.
I know exactly the place Michelle's at the moment because I've been there. The top that she had on, we could have both got in it, but you know what? That's what us girls do.
So you used to wear this then when you were 5 stone heavier?
No.
No. So you're still wearing the fat uniform of the baggy top?
It covers everything. It hides a multitude of sins because I'm still covering what I see as an unflattering body. I like that bit of...
Yeah.
I think that for Michelle today, more important than finding a dress is showing Michelle who she is under those baggy clothes. You know, she has to embrace it. She's got to love herself or she won't love herself in any dress.
What about this one? Did you not like that one?
I do, because it tired my stomach.
It's about giving her a bit of confidence to believe that she can do this.
Right, how are we doing, Michelle?
I really, really love this one. Really love it. But I did say I wanted sleeves and I fit on my sleeves.
Come with me. So Jo tells me you've lost 5 stone.
Yeah.
That's incredible. How long has it taken you to lose that weight?
A year. Yeah, a long, hard year. Been hard work.
So what dress size was you before you started the weight loss?
I was 30, going on like a 32.
What?
Yeah, I'm now more of a 22, 24-ish.
No way.
Yeah.
Well, can I just say, this is a size 20, and it's a little bit big for you.
Oh, God.
So you're not a 24 or a 22. I would say, at the moment, definitely your waist here is between an 18 and a 20.
Oh, God.
So that's made your day, isn't it?
Yeah. Yeah, definitely.
She is seeing all the negative and bad parts of herself that nobody else is seeing. So it's more than finding the right dress today. It's getting Michelle to look in the mirror, appreciate the new shape she's got and learning to accept it.
OK, open your eyes.
Look at your tiny waist. You've been hiding that. Oh, Michelle. Oh!
You realise now, like, how well you've done.
It doesn't look like me. It just, at that moment, it kind of just all smacked me in the face and just, like, hit me. Like, whoa, actually, you do look really good. It was an amazing feeling to think that I can actually look beautiful in a dress.
So we don't have a comparison yet. So, do you want to do another?
Yeah, please.
This might not be the dress, but do you know what? It was the dress that turned it around. That's a huge, huge step in the right direction.
Next to arrive at the boutique for her final fitting is size 28 Lauren. She found her dress 9 months ago, but the appointment didn't go the way she'd planned.
I really wanted sleeves, you know, I really just like my arms, but then trying on dresses with Jo and Al, the ones with sleeves didn't really look very nice.
I feel like a joint of gammon.
Oh, no.
I did go away with a dress without sleeves and I felt happy with that. I feel beautiful.
Do you?
That's it, that's it.
So my weight has gone up a little bit since when I first got the dress. Over time then, as the wedding got closer, I started panicking about my arms again. You know, it is a big deal to me in my mind.
Oh, hello, sweetie.
Tell me about the dress. You've had some changes, haven't you?
So Matt's mum made me a wrap to go with it.
I'm a little bit excited.
It was, we wanted arms covered and then we didn't want arms covered.
I've just got something if I want to wrap it round. I might not.
Bit of a comfort blanket.
Yeah. On my wedding day, it's important to me to feel and look the best I can. Obviously for myself and for Matt to see me like that as well. And obviously it's just a chance to be a bride, isn't it?
Okay.
Ready?
Mm-hmm.
Open your eyes.
Oh, I look so lovely.
You do.
I think if I had to walk down the aisle in the dress as it is now with my arms exposed, I'm just gonna not feel as confident and as happy.
So should we have a little look with the wrap?
Yeah.
Wondering what it's gonna be like. Is it gonna do the job? Is it gonna go with the dress? Because if it doesn't, we don't have a lot of time.
Are you planning on having it tied or are you gonna keep it together with your arms?
I don't know really. I
have to say, I'm quite surprised why we went with a satin though.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, only because it's almost like introducing another fabric to the dress.
Oh, yeah.
Whereas if you'd have had one in this.
Yeah.
I'm sure it came from a good place, and I'm sure that her mother-in-law thinks it's going to be amazing and do exactly what Lauren wants it to do. Problem is, not with this dress. And not only that, because satin's quite heavy and it's double-layered, it's not going to drape particularly prettily, if you know what I mean.
The material that she got, really.
Yeah.
I'm just going to lose this just for a sec.
I know that they know, obviously, what they're talking about, so I do trust them completely. And if they say it doesn't go, then it doesn't go, so.
I'm just going to use these two veils just to show you kind of if it was a tall one.
Yeah, so
it kind of... For a start, it kind of matches.
Yeah.
It's... So, what do you think of that?
Yeah, that looks much better. And it's like, I can't really even tell it's there.
Yeah.
It all just came together. It kind of made the dress look complete. So I'm really happy that Jo and Elle come in to get me in the dress on the day. They need to kind of make the sleeve look perfect. I guess I'm just anxious for it to look great.
So have an amazing week.
Thank you.
We shall see you, oh my God.
On Saturday.
Six days. Don't stress.
Right, coming in. I think after the initial shock of Michelle seeing herself in a dress, now is the time to go in for her favourite dress. If she puts this dress on and hates it, we're going right back to square one.
I feel a bit nervous.
I do, actually.
Open your eyes.
Wow.
It's beautiful.
That is. Gorgeous.
Wow.
Oh, she's off again.
No, it is absolutely beautiful.
I love that one.
It was like swishy and I kept stroking it.
I think we could just tweak it a bit, just a tiny bit, just to make her feel a little bit more comfortable with her arms.
Do you want to try the ostrich feather little bolero?
Yeah, try it.
Oh, I love that.
Oh, that's lovely.
Stunning. It is, it's beautiful. I just felt amazing in it.
So tell me, Michelle, is this your dress?
I think so.
I do.
She does. This is amazing. The appointment today has been a big eye-opener for me. And I do think that this is going to be a new day for me, thinking, wait a minute, you don't look half bad.
She looks amazing. Her confidence is just going to grow and grow. And on the day, she's going to walk in there and rock that frock.